Hello friends, welcome to another video. This video we are going to look into paginated reports. I have done many videos on paginated report. You can check out the paginated report playlist on my channel. In this video we're going to explore why we need to use measures in DAX queries in paginated report even if we are not using the measures in the report. This question was posted by someone who looked at my video, and they commented on that one is like why we need to use measure in the DAX query. We will look into the Power BI data model. Again, this is purely based on when you're using Power BI data set as a source in your paginated report. If you're using any other source, like you're connecting directly to SQL Server or other sources in your paginated report, then this is not a valid video for that purposes. It's purely for the purpose of if you're using Power BI data set as in a source to the paginated report. First, we will look into our data model, and then we will use that the data set of the data model in our paginated report and understand why we need to include the measures in our DAX queries in paginated report. So here in Power BI, what I have is a very, very simple model. I have a sales fact table, three-dimension table, calendar, product, dim customer. I'm not going through the modeling concepts here. So pretty much star schema and everything connected with the fact table. So let's say if we have an ask here is that I want to have a list of the customers and the product, but I don't want any measures. I just want a list of product and customer to show in a table visual in Power BI. I already created one page here. In this page, as you see, I dropped the customer column from my customer table and the product column from my product table. And if you look at the first customer, it's sorted by customer Aaron Adams. So what we're seeing here is it has only four products, right? And if I actually filter on Aaron Adams here, what we see here is we only see four products. And the reason, even we are not using any measure in this visual, but we are still getting those products for the customer which are sold to that specific customer. And it's not showing all the products in this list. But let's go to paginated report and try to create the same table in paginated report and see what happens there. Let's switch to paginated report. But before that, I just want to let you know the model which you saw in Power BI desktop. I already published that model in my Power BI service in the workspace and already created a connection to that because I want to make sure to show how that work in Power BI desktop and how it works in the paginated report. So I already created a connection in this paginated report, and then we will pick the columns to create the similar table in the paginated report here. All right, so let's create a data set in which we will bring customer and product as the columns what we need for our report here. So we just give it a data set, keep the same name. So I'm picking up my data source. Again, this is what I have already published in the Power BI service. So if we go to Query Designer here, in Query Designer, what we will do is again, we have the same model here. We will pick the product from our product table and customer from our customer name from our customer table. So dim, that's what exactly we did in Power BI desktop. So product and customer here. So that's the two columns we need because in Power Paginated Report, we're trying to mimic what we did in the Power BI desktop. We have a customer and then we have a product in there. So if we pick these two, once we say okay, it is going to create the DAX query for us automatically. Here you go. So we have this DAX query here, pretty straightforward. So basically evaluate, summarize columns, product and customer. So that's pretty much it. And now we will click OK. And now it is pretty straightforward. Here it is. So what I will do is I will insert a table here and on my, and then we will use the column customer and product. So pretty straightforward. This is exactly what we did in Power BI Desktop. We have a customer and a product. And now if I run this, I know this is not going to work. It's going to take forever to run and bring the result. Whereas in Power BI Desktop, it took like immediately as soon as you drop the columns. And I will explain why this is happening. Let's wait for a few seconds here. But I know this is not going to work. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop it. And filter our data for one specific customer so that we can learn it better what is happening here. So we go to design here again. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to edit the query and go to query. And what I'm going to do is I'm here going to filter it for one particular customer, just for the demo purpose, to explain what is happening. So if I add that into the parameter section here, I go equal, and then I'm going to select Aaron Adams. As we did that in Power BI Desktop, we will pick one customer here. So what we're basically doing here is we are just filtering our data set in Paginated report for this query for one particular customer. So now let's say okay. And that's pretty much it. If we look at the query, because it did not show the query, but let's go to data set properties here. It probably added a filter in here. So as you can see, before it was summarized column, product customer, and then it added the filter. So basically it's saying, filter the customer dimension table on Aaron Adams, because we give the hard-coded value that we want to filter it for Aaron Adams only. So now if I run this, I expect to see the result here because I have filtered it for one particular customer, but the result will be something which we don't expect. So here you go. What we see here is, I don't know why it's giving a empty rows here, but if you see Aaron Adams, it is showing us way too many products, and if you look into that, it's giving all the products. So basically what is happening at this point of time, when we are creating a query or picking up the columns in Paginated report, it get the DAX query, it has the product and the customer, and then we filtered for one particular customer, it is giving us all the product for that in our product table for each customer. So basically, if we don't filter it for one particular customer, we are getting Cartesian product. Basically, for each customer, we are getting all the product. So let's say if we have 1,000 customers and 1,000 products, so we are getting 1,000 multiplied by 1,000, these many rows. But when I filter it for one particular customer, now it is only one customer and 1,000 products, so 1,000 rows. But going back to Power BI, now the question comes is what happens in Power BI? Whereas in Power BI, it automatically gives us only those products which are sold for that customer. Like in Aaron Adams, in this particular case, if I filter it for one customer, it only gave me 4 products, not all the products. Whereas Paginated report giving me the list of all the products we have in our product table. So why it is working like this? What is happening? Why desktop is not working the same way as the Paginated report? Basically, we are doing the same action. In desktop, we are just on a table visual, drag the customer column, dropped in the table visual, and grab the product and dropped into the table visual, and we did nothing, anything else. And it gave us correct number of values there. But whereas in Paginated report, it were completely different. Now, to understand this, let's go back to Power BI Desktop here. So what happens in Power BI Desktop? If you guys use Performance Analyzer in the past, you will understand it better. So if I go in a Performance Analyzer, and let me refresh this start recording, and then refresh this visual. And now it created the query for this. So that we want to understand what query it has created in Power BI Desktop and what query it has created in Paginated Reports. So if I copy the query here, and I will paste it in a notepad here. Give me a quick second. So I copy the query in the notepad here. And if you look into this query, it's way different than what Power BI Paginated Report has done. So basically, what it did is it created a table which is for PeryTUS, basically filtering for Aaron Adams. And then the point is the summarize column. This is the query here. So same we have in Paginated Report, we have a summarize columns, and then we have a dim customer, dim product, and then it is filtering for Aaron Adams. I have another filter in Paginated Report, which is Canada and United States, in Power BI Desktop of Canada, United States, but that's not gonna make a, that's not the reason why we are seeing different result in Paginated Report and Power BI. It's added those filters. And then one thing it does is it automatically added this measure on the fly, because if you look into this in our model to understand it better, dim customer and dim product does not have any relationship. And in Power BI Paginated Report, because it doesn't have the relationship, it gives us like a Cartesian product. Basically, each customer has each product. So it's a huge list. Whereas when it automatically writes the query in Power BI Desktop, the engine is smart enough to add a measure from the sales table, because again, the sales table is a fact table. So basically, because of this count row sales it added, it automatically reduced the list of products which are it is showing in the visual, because it is now only showing those visuals which has the sales, or because count rows, if a product does not have the sales and any row sales with any rows, it will not show those products. And similarly, if a customer does not have any sales, it will not show those customers as well. So when it is creating the query in Power BI Desktop, it is smart enough to, if there is no measure in the visual, it will not add that measure. It will automatically add in this measure by itself, but it doesn't do in the Paginated Report. And if I add a measure here in this visual, let's say if I add a sales, I already have a sum sales measure, which is just a simple sum sales, and I drop that and keep it, I don't want it to auto change it, and keep it like this. Now, again, if you see Aaron Adams, this is the sale, and that's the same thing is working. And now if I go to performance analyzer here, and if I grab the query now, copy query, and we will look into this query now, everything will remain the same, but instead of the automatically added measure, it will be now a sales measure in place of that. So I just copy that. So as you can see now, our query would look like totally different. It is summarize columns because role add, it added because we want to as a total line. But end of the day, what it is what it did is customer and the product, and then the apply the filter, and then there is a measure dollar sales. And now it did not add that automatic measure into this query. But whereas going to Paginated Report, again, let's look at the query. What it did is it actually does not have any measure in here, and that's why it is showing all the product for each customer, and it will show all the customers all the products. So this is where you have to make sure that you are adding a measure in your visual, depending on what in your query, to reduce the size of the data it returns. Lord, many times people comes and ask this question, okay, I grab these dimension columns in Paginated Report, and now my report does not run. And that is the reason, because there is no measure, and it is returning the Cartesian table now, a list of every possible combination, and that can be huge. So if I add the dollar sales here, a measure, if you don't have a measure, you can just write a, whatever the way your tables are connected, a fact table, I expect a measure in the model, but then you have to add a measure to avoid that the whole, set of Cartesian table to be get returned. So now what I did is a product, customer, and sales. I added this, and I go okay. I'm just still keeping it filtered for one particular customer right now, Aaron Adams. And now If you look at the query here, it says summarize column dim product customer and filtering it for one particular customer, Aaron Adams, and then the Meyer, which is dollar sales. And now if we go OK, and even we don't need to show the sales here, we don't need to show the sales dollars here. And if I run this now, I will expect to see only those four or five product for this particular customer. Here you go. So it's only showing us three. I think there must be a second page. Or anyhow, whatever the reason, it is showing these empty lines. But now you can see it is returning a only product which are sold to Aaron Adams. End of the day, the goal of this particular video was to showcase that the action you do or the visualization you create in Power BI Desktop, not necessarily if you do the similar thing in Paginated report, it will work the same thing or will give the same output. In this very simple example, we just want a list of customers and the product. And in Power BI Desktop, it was smart enough to automatically add a measure and only reduce or give the list of those customers and product which has some sales. Whereas in Paginated report, it created, we did the same thing. We brought the product and customer from a dimension table, and then it created the DAX query, which does not have any measure. And all of a sudden it give it, if I don't filter it for one particular customer, that query will run forever because it's going to make all the possible combination, all the product, all the customers, and it's going to be huge a table, and which is taking forever to run. I hope you learned some of the insights about how this works, how Power BI creates the DAX query, and how Paginated report works a little bit differently, and what you need to do if you run into similar challenge where you are dragging the columns from the dimension tables and it is taking forever to run your reports. Let me know what you guys think about this video, and make sure to check out the other Paginated report playlist. I have some interesting videos on that. And make sure to subscribe, and please like the videos, and hit the bell icon to get notified when the new videos comes out. Thanks for watching. Have a good day. Bye for now. Take care.